add, 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 add. Okay, this has to stop. I'm gonna show you how to get rid of all the ads. And we're gonna do more than just a simple browser extension. We're gonna block it at the source and protect your entire network, your entire house, your entire family from these ads. This is AdGuard.
No, that's a spider.
No, I'm gonna murder you and your entire family.
Nope, I didn't get him. He's gone.
He's coming towards me. He's like got my sock and my mouth.
But you can't block all the ads, like this one here. Go ahead, try, block it. You can't, because IT Pro TV, it's too awesome.
I'm Captain AdGuard.
IT Pro TV, too awesome. I wanna get my CCNA.
So while they duel that out, let's talk about what we're doing. We're going to install AdGuard in your home network and it will block all the ads. I'll show you how to install on a Raspberry Pi, which, wait, I may have to borrow one, hold on. Yep, I'm gonna have to borrow it from the cluster. Sorry, cluster.
Ah, dropped a pie!
Yeah, this thing's falling apart.
Okay, Raspberry Pi. And I'll show you on a cloud machine, a VPS. So you can share it with your friends and family and protect everybody. It's kinda cool. I'll also show you how to do it on Docker. And because Docker can go anywhere, you can install this on pretty much anything, anywhere. You can install anywhere. Thought that would roll off the tongue better. God, I need some more coffee. So you can put this thing anywhere. Raspberry Pi, cloud, whatever, you have no excuses. So get your coffee ready, let's kick some ads. Now before we can block the ads, we have to learn how they work, how they tick. So watch this, and it's pretty crazy. I'm gonna fire up Wireshark. I'll start a trace and I'll filter off of DNS. When I go to cnet.com, you can see here in Wireshark that I asked my DNS server, hey, where does CNET live? What's its IP address? There's my request, and then the response from my DNS server. But hold up, what's all this other stuff? Are you seeing this? We got match.adserver.org. That's an ad. In fact, I think a lot of these are ads, and these are all DNS requests. So not only are we asking, hey, what's cnet.com, but we're also asking, hey, what's adserver.com? And give me ads, I love ads.com. And just like any web page, our DNS server responds with the IP address of those ad servers, and our ads pop up. Now, what if we did this? What if we had a DNS server that would give us cnet.com? Yeah, we wanna see that. NetworkChuck.com, whatever it is. But when we asked for an ad, or when our browser asked for an ad, it didn't respond. It didn't tell us where it was. It didn't tell us the IP address. It just threw it into a hole and said, don't come back. That's what AdGuard does. When our browser asks for adserver.com, or give us ads, I love ads.com, AdGuard, our new DNS server, will respond with nonsense, nothing. And because we can't reach out to the ad server and pull down the ad, it doesn't load, we don't see it. Watch this, I wanna use AdGuard right now. This is straight up magic. Now watch what happens when I go to cnet.com. Like, look at all this, all these ad URLs. My computer's asking for them, hey, give them to me. He's an addict, addict, like that. But then look what AdGuard responds with. 0.0.0.0, nonsense, nothing, a sinkhole. In fact, this technique is called a DNS sinkhole. And all the ads get sucked in and they die. They do. And we don't see them anymore. And that's the power of AdGuard. But that's just half the story of why you might want to use AdGuard. Yes, ads suck. But the other reason you want to do this is security and privacy. Because right now, if you're not using your own DNS server, buddy, you don't have it. Now, I'm warning you right now. If you haven't changed your DNS settings, this is you. Because by default, everything in your home network is using the DNS server provided by your ISP, your internet service provider. Which is okay, right? Because they're totally trustworthy. Not. And they're all up in your business. Every website you visit, they see it. Not that you have anything to hide, right? Do you? Too late, they already know. They already know that you went out to itprotv.com. And you won't stop watching it because it's so entertaining and it's gonna change your life because you're getting new IT skills. They know all that. We don't want them to know that you're gonna get your CCNA or your A+ or your Linux Plus or any of the latest and greatest IT skills that'll help you change your life and get a better job. We don't want them to know that. Even though IT Pro TV is crazy entertaining. And if you check my link below, you'll get 30% off forever. So let's stop them from knowing that. So by using our own DNS server, we get our privacy back, but we also get control. Get out of here, evil ISP. Leave me alone. With AdGuard, you can actually control what people access on your network. There are probably some things you don't want your kids seeing. You can block that. Actually, for your kids, just block everything but IT Pro TV and Network Chuck. Like, that's what you gotta do. And with AdGuard, you can do that. You're welcome. So now that you're already sold, let's take a quick sip of coffee. And let's set AdGuard up. It'll take about 5 minutes. Not even kidding. We'll start with Mac and Linux first, which of course does include our Raspberry Pi. I was holding that weird. Now, if you're working with a fresh Raspberry Pi and you're actually able to get your hands on one, how did you do that? Then you'll want to do a headless install, which means you won't need a monitor or keyboard to make this thing work. Just the Pi itself, an SD card, which I have right here, and a power cable. And an Ethernet cable if you want to hardwire it. And setting up Raspberry Pis nowadays are pretty stinking easy. Just take your SD card, find yourself an SD card reader, which I don't know where mine is. I'll be right back. Found it! Whoa. We'll plug that sucker in. Plug it into our computer. Download and run the Raspberry Pi imager, which is amazing. I'll have all of this in a link below, by the way. We'll choose Raspberry Pi OS Lite as our OS, 32-bit. Choose our storage, choose wisely. And before you click on write, calm down, click on the little gear icon there, and we'll do some Raspberry Pi headless action here. Enable SSH, set a password, and even configure wireless if you're gonna do that. I'm gonna hardwire mine. Click save, and write. And yeah, quick coffee break. When it's done, take it out, put it back into your Pi, or put it into your Pi for the first time, I don't know where you're at. And then power that sucker up and wait for it to boot. And while you're waiting for it to boot, go ahead and check your router to see what IP address it gets. Because your router is the one who gives it its IP address and its DNS server. And I just found mine. Once you find yours, go ahead and launch CMD in Windows or a terminal in Mac and Linux and SSH into that bad boy. Now, if you want to do it in the cloud, just choose your cloud provider of choice. I like Linode. Just fire up one of their smaller boys here. And once it's done cooking, go ahead and SSH into that box, and we'll keep going. Now, the commands will be the same across the board. Mac or Linux doesn't matter. We'll first start out with a sudo apt update. Like always, you have to do an update. Coffee break. Oh, it's a little cold. Once your list is up to date, go ahead and copy and paste this command. It's really scary, very long, but it's automatic, and you don't have to worry about it. So go ahead and hit enter, and let the magic happen. Now, what it's doing here is actually done. That was quick. AdGuard Home is now installed and running. And that's exactly what we installed. I was about to explain that before it rudely interrupted me. AdGuard has a lot of different products, but we installed AdGuard Home. It is completely free and completely awesome. Now also notice here in the output, it tells us we can go to this address at port 3000 to access the GUI. Let's go ahead and do that right now. I'm going to grab that, launch my web browser, and go through the Get Started menu. When in doubt, don't change a thing. Click on Next, set up a username and password. Don't use admin. I'm just doing this for example. And then here's probably the most important part. Because like right now, you do have AdGuard set up, and it's beautiful, and it's amazing. It's ready to be used. But it's not being used yet because nothing knows about it. You gotta tell your computers, your phones, your watches, and all the stuff in your house, your TVs and your Xboxes, you gotta tell it to use this DNS server. But how? Well, AdGuard is here to tell you, right here. It tells you how to do it. If you're a glutton for punishment, you could go out to each individual device. Windows, Mac, Android, iOS, and change it on each device. Change the DNS server. That's not fun. Don't do that. Please don't do that. What you want to do is what it's telling you right here. Change the DNS server on your router. Now, I would love to walk you through that, but every router is different. But where you'll want to be is you want to change your DHCP settings. Because whenever your device, your phone, whenever it connects to your network, it'll reach out to your router, which is normally the DHCP server, and it'll say, hey, give me an IP address. I want to surf the web. And it'll give it an IP address, but also it'll give it a default gateway and a DNS server. What we want to do is make sure it's getting the DNS server of our AdGuard little box here we set up. Mine is 10.70.2.60. Whatever yours is, put it there. Now on that same note, you wanna make sure that the AdGuard server, your server you just set up, we wanna make sure its IP address doesn't ever change. There are two ways you can do that. One's easy, one is hard. Easy is to set a DHCP reservation on your router. Again, I can't walk you through that. Every router is different. That's what it's called. And it allows you to always have the same IP address given to that device no matter what. The second option is to hard code an IP address on that server. I'm not gonna cover that here, but I do have links below where you can find out. A fun fact for all you nerds out there, AdGuard can also be a DHCP server. Now, it won't replace your router, don't do that. But it can serve the function as DNS and DHCP. Now, once you've changed the DNS server that your router hands out via DHCP, you're pretty much golden. It'll happen automatically, but not immediately. By default, your device's IP address reservation is about 24 hours. So it might take that long, give or take. Now, for a lot of you, that's all you care about. Like right now, your ads are being put into a hole. Goodbye, ads. But if you're a nerd like me and you have some extra coffee in your cup, there are some more advanced things you might want to learn about, know about, and mess with right now. Let's look at it real quick. Coffee break. Go ahead and click continue to finish up your setup. And once you have, you're here. Now I'm going to switch to my cloud-based server because I already set that up earlier. And it's already got some queries. Already got some stuff to mess with. But it's still the default setup. Now I'll speed around just a couple of things. First, if I go to settings, up at the top here, and go to general settings, general settings. You got some things if you want to make your house a bit more kid-friendly, like parental control service, and safe search, which are very cool. You can also make sure that statistics are kept longer than 24 hours. Let's go 90 days, why not? And then going back up to settings, let's go to DNS settings, kind of the reason we're here, right? Here is where the real power of being secure and protected with your DNS stuff comes in. So AdGuard itself does not resolve IP addresses to domain names. It relies on other DNS servers, upstream DNS servers. By default, it includes one from Quad9, which is actually totally great. But you can add more. But I want to talk about this real quick. Notice it's a kind of a URL, HTTPS, and it's a domain name. First, I want you to know that you're using secure DNS. It's actually called DOH, or DNS over HTTPS, and your DNS queries are encrypted from AdGuard to the upstream server. So not only can your ISP not see what's going on, no one can. You're good. And if you want to add more, as I might expect you do, you can click on the list of known DNS providers right here. And there are a ton, a lot to go through, but I'll show you the ones I like. First, Quad9. The default one's okay, but it doesn't include a security block list or DNSSEC, which DNSSEC is amazing. It actually verifies every DNS response you get, making sure it's legit. Because DNS can be poisoned, you can receive fake responses, and that's a very popular hacking attack. I believe I have a video on it somewhere. If I don't, I should make one. But DNSSEC saves the day. So I like to use this one right here, because it gives you protection against phishing, spyware, and everything else I mentioned already. So I'll just grab that address and copy it and paste it in there instead of that guy. And the two others I like, I'll just paste right here, are Google and Cloudflare. All three of these do DOH and DNSSEC, which means they check my boxes, and I'll go ahead and load balance across all of these. Now scrolling down, you do have the option of adding your own private reverse DNS servers. So if you have another DNS server in your house or at your business, you can add that here. And then down here under DNS server configuration, you do want to enable DNSSEC. Keeping in mind a DNSSEC enabled resolver is required, but we just covered that, we're good to go. And then I'll go ahead and click on save. That's all I care about here. Now I'm not gonna cover every setting because there are a million, but a few more things I have to tell you because it's so cool. Let's go to the top, go to settings. We're not gonna look at encryption settings, but you should try it, it's pretty cool. But if you click on client settings, here's where you can control what individual devices have access to on your network. You can apply separate policies and all kinds of crazy things. These are called persistent clients, so cool. And then I'm gonna skip on over to filters up at the top here. Here is where it gets pretty cool. Here I'll click on DNS block list, and you can actually add more things that can block more things. So by default, the AdGuard DNS filter is blocking, or has 48,000 rules blocking a ton of ads. You can add more. Add more. In fact, just by clicking add block list, you can add a bunch more from their list. Dan Pollock, whoever that guy is. Game console ad block. This guy. Click save, and suddenly you're blocking more and more stuff, just like that. I love it. Going back up to filters, you can allow certain domains that might be blocked by one of your lists. Might be kind of cool. Might be what you need. You can also do DNS rewrites. And this feature I love because all the other ad blockers out there don't really do this. I'm looking at you, Piehole. Yeah, you don't do this. Now, what am I talking about? Well, you can add your own DNS entries here. So for example, I might want to access AdGuard here. AdGuard. For me.local. That's what I'll access. I'll just call it that. And I'll have it go to this IP address. Bam. So now when I go to adguardforme.local, bam, it's there. And you can do this for anything in your house, your own DNS entries, which is powerful and fun. Now, just a few more things. Block services. This is something you may want to do, especially if you have kids. Or maybe you're trying to stay productive. So block all of these, Disney Plus, Facebook, Instagram, and just keep IT Pro TV open. Because that's all you should be watching right now anyway. I mean, my YouTube channel, and then also IT Pro TV. And then one last thing I want to show you, we got our query log, where you can see all the queries, everything coming through. And that's all I'm going to show you. Again, there's a lot more to AdGuard, but this should be enough to get you excited and get started. And honestly, it's going to make your experience surfing the web a lot better. It could even make your internet a bit faster, but for sure, 100% safer. And ad-free. Don't forget about that. That's it. Video over.